Don't you wish you took action? Imagine 5 years down the line, future you, and he did everything. He never once procrastinated, and he set out to achieve every single goal he wanted, and he accomplished it. Imagine the life that he would be living in 5 years' time, the future you, if you had done everything you wanted. Imagine the life he would be living. That dream life you want, he would be living. That girl, that family, that business, that wealth, that freedom, he would be living it. He would have completely changed his life. So how do you do that? How do you change your life? First things first, how are you? I hope things have been good and I hope you've been alright. There's a chance no one has asked you that today. Now, there is one thing that I've done. You know, I went from the kid who worked a 9-to-5 job or like in a restaurant, you know, 11 a.m. to 11 p.m, 12-hour shifts, getting home at 2 in the morning, waking up, going to work, waking up 20 minutes before I had to go work again at 11 a.m, and then on my days off, I just go out drinking. I went from that life in just a couple months, completely transforming it and living a completely different life, you know, going on to self-improvement. 2 years down the line from then, I'm now consistently getting up at 6 every single morning, going to the gym every single day, except my rest day, which is one day a week. Consistently eating the good habits, meditating, gratitude journaling, focusing on my purpose, doing this every single day. How? How did I change my life so drastically? Living life way more satisfaction. With way more satisfaction. Sorry, I can't speak. English is actually not my first language, even though it is. And the way I did this was journaling. Now, the reason journaling is so good, I think the best way to put it is like, every time I'm skating or like a friend is in the skate park, you know, trying a new trick on their skateboard, right? They'll ask me or someone to, I'll ask someone to film it. I'll do the trick, it messes up, I'll look at the video, and just by seeing the video, I'll know what I'm doing wrong. And I'll be like, oh, cool, I know what I need to do now. I go do it, and I land it first try. You know, a lot of people do this, especially with, like, gaming as well. A lot of people, like, to get better at gaming, they'll record their gameplay, and they'll look at what they're doing. And it's weird, because I've implemented that sort of tactic into real life, and it's journaling. Journaling is basically the same thing. It's not something that's going to change your life in 5 minutes, but journaling is designed to tweak your habits slightly to benefit you in the long run. So in 5 years' time, you will be that dream person that you're trying to be. But how to journal? No one knows how to actually even start journaling. And this is something I want you to do within the next 10 days. You can do this quicker if you want, but I want you to write down, journal, and I want you to answer 10 questions within the next 10 days. One question a day. So you're, you know, consistently journaling every single day. It'll get you into the habit of journaling. You know, about your day, about what you've done, about the things you achieved, the things you maybe didn't achieve. Implementing in you journaling your day. I want you to ask yourself these 10 questions. Now, the first one. What would I do if money was no object? What would you genuinely do if money was not a thing? You know, a lot of the things we do is revolved around money. It's sometimes the motivation behind the actions we take. So if money was not a thing, ask yourself, what would you do to pass the time? What would you do with your talents and how would you help other people? It's a very, very kind of almost a quick way to sort of narrow down to your purpose, what it is you want to do in life. Ask yourself, what it is you would do if money was no object. What would you do? Imagine you had all the time in the world, but then you'd get bored, right? So what thing would fill up that time? What would you do? The second question, what would you want people to say at your funeral? Now, this is quite a dark question, and the reason why this is something that I think is really good is because it really gives you a sense of clarity and meaningfulness to what it is you're doing. It helps you really stick to what it is you're trying to stay consistent at. Say, for example, you're going to the gym a lot. You're starting to go and you're worried if you'll maybe fall off one day. Or maybe you're having a bad day and you don't really want to go. You don't really want to be consistent. Like today, I didn't want to go to the gym today. I just wanted to go home. But I went. Do you know why? Because I thought to myself, when at my funeral, what are people going to say about me? That's Wylder. That's Sean Wylder. That's the guy who helped as many as he could on YouTube, on helping others avoid the mistakes he made. And he went to the gym. He was very attractive. You know, he put in the effort. He put in the hours. He aimed so hard to improve himself on this journey. He did pretty good. That's the end of my journey. I'm not there yet, obviously. I'm not there yet, but that's the end of my journey. What do you want people to say at your funeral? The next question. All of our decisions compound over the long term. Now, I want you to think 7 days. The last 7 days, last week, if you had to repeat what you did in those last 7 days for the next week, for 10 years, where would you be? Who would you be in the future? If you had to repeat what you've done, your actions that you took the last 7 days, if you had to repeat every single week for the next 10 years, who would you be? And would you be happy with where you are right now? And if not, what could you change? The next question is the past 2 weeks. How has the past 2 weeks made you feel? How has the past 2 weeks been? This is something that you can ask like every 2 weeks or something, or like even every day if you wanted to. But how has the last 2 weeks been for you? What made you happy? What things made you sad? What things made you energized? What things made you drain your energy? Focus on the things that you do within those past 2 weeks, because the way you live your week is the way you will live your life. Now, the next question is kind of a little bit more. You need a little writing on your part, a little diagram of sorts, like a scale system from 1 to 10. And it's the wheel of life. The wheel of life. So I want you to split your life into 3 categories: health, relationships, and work. Health, your physical health, your mental health, all that kind of stuff. Your relationships, you know, sexual relationships with...
Cut that.
Relationships, so, you know, sexual relationships or friends or family. How are your relationships in real life? And then work, your mission, your purpose, the financial side to your life. Rate each category of your life, these 3 categories, rate each one on a scale of 1 to 10. 1 being shit and 10 being good. Are you happy where you are right now? And if not, what can you do to improve? What can you do to improve those scales? Now, the next thing I want you to ask yourself is, what is your Odyssey plan? Your Odyssey plan. I want you to ask yourself 2 questions. In 5 years' time, if I go down this current path I'm doing, where would I be? Or the things I'm doing right now, this current path I'm on, in 5 years' time, where would I be? And then I want you to ask yourself the second question, exact same thing, but what if it was a complete alternative thing? A complete alternative path. What if instead I did this, and in 5 years' time, where would I be? This will just help you kind of give you clarity that you have options. The next question, what is your goal? What is your current goal at the moment? And what is the bottleneck? What's the goal that you currently want to achieve right now? And it could be anything from big to small goals. And what's the thing that's stopping you, the bottleneck? What's the thing from stopping you from achieving those goals? The biggest thing that is stopping you. This question will literally cut straight to the heart with anything that you are struggling in, anything that you're struggling with right now. The next question is, what goals will have the greatest accomplishments on your life? The greatest positive effect. You see, if you had a wand right now, and like fucking Harry Potter, you waved it and every 24 hours, a goal that you wanted was accomplished. Just like that, instant. In a week's time, which goal will have made the biggest amount of change in your life, the most positive amount of change? This will just help you sort of clear up your priorities, helps clear out your mind, because your mind is probably crowded with a lot of things you want to do right now. Question number 9, the question for entrepreneurs, is the business that you're working in right now, does it serve you or are you serving it? You see, I worked for a really long time in the typical 9-to-5 life. Unbalanced, it wasn't really helping me. I was more or less serving that corporate company instead of serving myself and really feeling like myself. I think back and yeah, a lot A lot has changed, but when it comes down to it, what kind of person do you want to be? Do you want to have something that's working for yourself, or do you want to be working for someone else? And the last question, if I had 2 years left to live, what would I do? How would you live your life? What would you aim to achieve? And you can change this deadline. You know, try asking more questions like, if I had 5 years left to live, or if I had 10 years left to live, what would you do? And what would you accomplish? How would you go down in history? These are some very, very big questions. So that's why I've said space them out. Like, these 10 questions were over the next 10 days or over the next week. But genuinely journaling, just journaling my day and like the things I've accomplished and the things I maybe didn't accomplish and what I'm going to try and do tomorrow. Just journaling that just by itself every single day has helped me change my life drastically. It's like I'm, you know, keeping myself in check almost. It feels weird that such a tiny little habit tweaks so much of my life. And these big, big questions can really help you give you a sense of clarity on your life. Because sometimes that's what we need, just a clean piece of paper, a clean slate. Hopefully this video helped you out. And I hope things have been good. And I'd be really appreciative if you clicked on the video that's going to pop up in the corner here, because this video could help you out. And subscribe if you want to see more content like this. Stay consistent and don't give up. You know it, damn it is. My camera's really high up. So from Ruby is... Mwah!